This year marks the end of PS4's console reign, but we saw some amazing titles. Out of more than 1,000 releases, here are the 10 best PlayStation 4 games of 2020 arranged by PlayScore. Visit our website at whattoplay.com to see the complete list. You can also take part in our rankings by leaving reviews of the games that you played. Link in the description box below.
Stuffing, stuffing, stuffing away. What does the cup have to say?
I wanna play!
Opening our list of the top 10 PlayStation 4 games of the year 2020 is Studio MDHR's masterfully crafted run-and-gun platformer. Cuphead lets players relive the good old days of 1930s animation. As simple as their story is, the journey isn't exactly easy. Explore its surrealist landscapes full of odd characters. It features a classic run-and-gun style gameplay with hardcore boss battles to face. By hardcore, we mean super hard. During release, it was celebrated as one of the best platformers ever made. It also gave rise to a number of memes involving its challenging gameplay.
Now hear this!
The game's success was obvious. Everyone adored its art style and the responsive controls, not to mention its crazy co-op mode. It was just released on the PS4 earlier this year, and we can't wait for its upcoming DLC. A play score of 8.74. Big Slash is at number 9 with Nioh 2. The PlayStation 4 has a ton of samurai games that tend to compete with each other. 2020's samurai release was Ninja Theory's follow-up to their award-winning action RPG. It serves as a prequel to the original Nioh, and it'll take players once more into the yokai-corrupted lands of Nihon. For fans of hybrid hack-and-slash RPGs with Japanese settings, Nioh 2 delivers with more impressive set pieces and challenging boss battles that could rival the Soul series. The game even has a co-op mode to play with friends, but then again, a multiplayer mode on a single-player game isn't its strongest feature. IGN scored the game a 9 out of 10, quoting, "It's an impressive evolution of its predecessor, strengthening everything that was already great while mostly leaving its already existing issues alone." In addition to its already engaging main story, Nioh 2 is also getting DLCs coming soon with new stories and characters. It has a play score of 8.87. Floating into the number 8 spot is Dreams. Little Big Planet creator Media Molecule's ambitious IP creates a new path for the future of user-generated gaming communities. In Dreams, players create their own handcrafted world with an almost limitless amount of support. This includes creating fully-fledged projects with their own set of mechanics, assets, sculptures, music, and art. It encourages the young and old to make their own levels, be it comical, absurd, or thematic. It's more of a technical showcase than a video game. Dreams is Media Molecule's crowning achievement in video game creation. While it does have a short single-player campaign, it's intended to showcase the basics on what to expect when creativity is being tested. Critics are giving this perfect scores mainly due to its unlimited potential. It's a playground where anything can happen, all depending on community support and its growing customization options. A play score of 8.87. Locking Fists at number 7 with Streets of Rage 4. A sequel that took almost 3 decades to finally reach the modern audiences. It wasn't revolutionary, nor genre-defining. Instead, it was simply a return to the classics, bringing in a whole new audience to an old genre that once shaped gaming. Its success came from its hybrid of modern and old mechanics. Sure, its 2D gameplay feels dated, but the responsiveness of its controls is on par with modern game design, and not to mention its rocking soundtrack makes the experience feel new. Eric Halliday from AppTrigger said, "It's an incredible love letter to an already beloved franchise." He gave it a score of 9. A co-op mode is also present for those looking for a good time with friends. Take back the streets with up to 4 local co-op fun, or go online with up to 2 players. A play score of 8.90. At number 6 is The Last of Us Part 2. There is nothing more controversial than Naughty Dog's mastercrafted sequel of their award-winning IP. The winner of this year's The Game Awards, The Last of Us 2 doles out the depressing effects of humanity living under a post-apocalyptic world. It's dark, gritty, and full of emotional twists. While its criticisms stem from its risky narrative that shifts player expectations, the general reviews of TLOU 2 is somewhat positive. Its gameplay is brutal, and it's not afraid to take a huge leap in storytelling that would polarize their fanbase. IGN gave it a perfect score, stating that, It delivers a layered, emotionally shattering story on top of stealth and action gameplay that improves the first game's mechanics while integrating a bit more of Uncharted's greater mobility and action. It's truly a unique experience, but the story is not for everyone. Gamers rooting for the protagonist in a dystopian setting might find this underwhelming. Much of its praise comes from the game's main themes, which really puts into perspective humanity's flaws in a broken world. A play score of 8.90. Rip and tear at number 5 with Doom Eternal. Hell is just a four-letter word to the legendary Doom guy in this latest entry of the acclaimed first-person shooter from id Software. Equip an arsenal of high-powered weaponry to annihilate a legion of demons, whether it's by blowing their heads off with a shotgun or ripping them apart with a chainsaw. Eternal maximizes its moment-to-moment action, bringing in a brutal first-person shooter that's one for the ages. It is a worthy sequel to a storied franchise, a celebration of all things Doom, and one of the finest single-player first-person shooters ever made. Said Will Borger from Gaming Bolt, he gave it a 9 out of 10. While it does suffer from a narrative point of view, the fun of Doom isn't in its storytelling. It's the way we rip and tear those poor demons and send them to hell and back. A play score of 8.94. Swinging into the number 4 spot is Marvel's Spider-Man, Miles Morales. The latest chapter of Insomniac's award-winning superhero series takes players into the shoes of Peter Parker's young protege, Miles Morales. As a standalone open-world adventure, expect a shorter, more character-focused story centered around this web-slinging greenhorn as he finds his true calling. Explore the festive streets of New York while swinging to and fro with Miles Morales' exaggerated superhero swagger. Combat is electrifying and satisfying, all thanks to Miles' signature abilities. It's originally a PS5 launch title, but the PS4 gets to share the experience with minor performance issues, of course. One reviewer from Cultured Vultures captures the game's essence, saying, "There's enough content to satiate fans of the 2018 game or bring in new players who enjoyed the Into the Spider-Verse movie." It's nothing perfect since it serves as a DLC-like addition to the already great Spider-Man, but despite all of that, reviews are praising its tight-knit story and characters. A play score of 9.08.
If you continue down this path, you will be no better than the Mongols. I trained you to fight with honor.
Honor died on the beach. The Khan deserves to suffer.
Slashing into third place is Ghost of Tsushima, the other samurai game that came out this year. Like The Last of Us 2, Ghost of Tsushima was a PlayStation 4 swan song before the imminent release of the PS5. Taking place during the Mongol siege in Tsushima Island, players assume the role of Jin Sakai, a samurai torn between two codes. Combat gave this game its own identity. Each flurry of Jin's katana is done so with grace, creating an addicting combat experience not present in most samurai titles. Also, one of Ghost of Tsushima's strengths is its living open world. GameZone's 8.5 rating perfectly sums up the game, stating, "Its brutal yet eloquent gameplay and picturesque world never fail to capture you." Feudal Japan has never been this good on a video game before. Each location feels like it came straight out of a painting, and it demands gigabytes worth of PS4 screenshots. From golden leaves to war-torn villages, Tsushima breathes of wonder and ruin. A play score of 9.10. Breaking limits at number 2 is Final Fantasy VII Remake. A project that took almost a decade to complete, Square Enix's latest opus transformed their critically acclaimed Final Fantasy into a game perfect for the next generation. The graphics are ridiculously good. GamesRadar gave it a 4.5 out of 5, calling this entry a spectacle from start to finish. As a remake, everything in this game is rebuilt from the ground up. One would expect where the story would take them if they played the original, but Tetsuya Nomura's twists and turns might leave veteran players in for a surprise. Gameplay feels stylish yet tactical. Slow down time and pick from a wide variety of abilities that sends enemies a salvo of materia power. Some say it's the best combat in an FF game ever. Although it only presents the first few hours of the original, it never fails to capture the heart and soul of Midgar and Cloud's adventures with his friends within its broken world. A play score of 9.13.
The actions of the Phantom Thieves showed no sign of stopping.
And the best PS4 game of 2020 is none other than Persona 5 Royal. With all that port begging, it's pretty obvious why everyone would want a Persona 5 on their consoles. Live a double life and embrace the inner rebel to change society's heart and reform it. Atlas JRPG masterpiece wins the list of our top 10 best PlayStation 4 games of 2020. While it may sound weird considering it's a re-release with an expanded story and improved visuals, worry not, because Royal is not just a simple update, it's the perfect Persona 5 experience from start to finish. The addition of quality of life changes in its turn-based combat, new music, and a surprisingly adorable character makes Royal the best Persona game yet. Even GameSpot gave it a perfect 10, saying Persona 5 Royal asserts itself as an unforgettable and empowering RPG that should be recognized as one of the best games of our time. With our PlayScore system, the game receives a whopping 9.58.